What's up, Super Geeks? How's everyone doing today? I hope you're doing just fine. I'm having a swell day, and you know what? It's even better because I get to show you this really cool Batman Superman 2-pack. Now, I know if you're a Batman and Superman fan, you've probably seen this before. It's not anything new. It's actually from 2003, so it's quite old, but I haven't seen very many videos about this 2-pack on YouTube, and I figured, you know what? It's worth giving a mention because it gave us a really cool Superman figure. Now, this is the paint prototype on the back, and that's the paint prototype of the Batman. But it also gave us some really cool other figures, like probably, in my opinion, the most accurate Tim Drake Robin figure we've gotten, an excellent Joker figure, a 6-inch scale Batmobile and Batcopter, and it gave us a Mr. Freeze, it gave us a Catwoman, it gave us a ton of great figures. Yes, this line suffered from the whole Batman variant thing, where we get a million different Batman figures that ain't no one gives a crap about. But overall, this was a great line, and it paved the way for the DC Universe classics. So I'm going to open it up, and we're going to have a look together. Now, I know you're going to hate me for this, because I'm going to open this in the most sacrilege way, but I'm just ripping her apart. Just opening her up. Yep. Just going to take the back thing off, and there we go. Let's just get the wires off, and I'll stand them up, and I'll be back in a second. All right, now that we got both the figures out of the package, let's take a look at each one individually. Now, starting off with the Superman figure, we can see that this figure is most definitely inspired by the artwork of Jose Garcia Lopez. I mean, just taking a quick glance at this figure and looking at the face sculpt, I mean, to me, without a doubt, that's Jose Garcia Lopez's Superman likeness right there captured in action figure form. And you know what? I want to preface by saying that this Superman figure actually re-jumpstarted my entire action figure collecting obsession. I was taking a walk through the Zeller's toy department one day and I saw the 2-pack Superman Batman on a peg and I was like, oh my god, what is this fine specimen of a Superman figure there hanging on a peg? I took it home and I've been collecting like crazy ever since, and it's all thanks to this Superman figure from the Mattel Batman line from 2003-2002. Let's take a much closer look at this figure though. Now, it doesn't have all of the same articulation that a DC Universe Classics figure has, but it has some of it. The head just swivels. The head actually is not on a ball joint, which I'm okay with. The shoulders, they go out like that, and they're also, you know, they swivel. So it's got a lot of articulation in the shoulders. The elbows don't have a whole ton of articulation, but they have as much as I'm going to need just standing it on a shelf and posing it. The waist doesn't have ab articulation, but it does have the waist rotation. For me, that's just fine. I can have it or don't have to have it. The legs, they're simple hinge legs. They don't go out like the DC Universe Classics. The knees on these figures, just a basic knee hinge, and you have an ankle hinge too. And that's it. That's all you get for articulation on these figures, but really, at the time, that was still a ton of adequate articulation. You have to remember, these figures were also made with kids in mind, not just collectors. If there was one thing about this figure that I've always thought was really kind of silly and wonky, it's the design of the S on the cape. I look at that and I'm like, wow, they made the sculpt, and then they were like, how do we paint an S on the back of that cape to make it accurate? And they were just like, ah, screw it. Let's just throw some paint at the back of the cape and hope it looks like an S. So that's the only thing I would ever change about this figure is the wonky, ridiculous, drunk-looking S on the back of his cape. I think that the color of this figure is better than the DC Universe Classic Superman. I think the S on this figure is better than the DC Universe Classic Superman. I think that the actual sculpture of this figure is better than the DC Universe Classic Superman figure. And if this figure would fit with the DC Universe Classics better, I probably would have just used him and not bought the DC Universe Classics figure version. Alas, he's too small, so he ends up being in a league all of his own. And next up, we see the Batman figure from the 2-pack. And again, this seems like a really excellent effort on Mattel's part to give us a comic-accurate Batman of the day. Now, this Batman was single-carded at first, before he ended up in the 2-pack. So, I mean, you could have very well already had this Batman figure by way of buying him single-carded. He came with, an accessory. I think it was like a grappling line accessory or whatever. But if you just wanted the figure and you never had a chance to get it single carded and you saw this hanging on the shelf with the Superman figure, it was a dream come true as far as I'm concerned. So taking a closer look though, we can tell, and it seems pretty obvious to me, that the facial sculpt and the body sculpt, the whole thing is again based off of Jose Garcia Lopez's artwork. Backing up a little bit, we can see that the comic styling of this figure is Very recognizable at first glance. The yellow belt, the solid bat on the chest, the black and gray motif. There's nothing about this figure that says they missed anything, and I can appreciate that. Now, this figure does come with a cloth goods cape, and a lot of people really like the cloth goods cape. They didn't do a bad job of this cape. It does the job. Like, they bunched it up in the middle there, kind of. I prefer if it went over the shoulders a bit, but I get it. Again, this figure was made with kids in mind as well, and that's evident because every time I go to a thrift store, I find one of these in a baggie for like $1.99 with a bunch of other toys. So kids clearly owned these figures. Having a peek at the articulation of this figure, it doesn't have quite as much as Superman, but it has some. It has the shoulder articulation just the same, but it does not have the elbow articulation. It's all solid there, but it has this glove articulation, so the glove can rotate. Same thing with the other arm. It doesn't have any ab articulation. It does rotate at the waist, but it doesn't have any ab articulation, which again is fine by me. Regular old, you know, back and forthy legs, and you got the regular old knee joint hinges, and nothing on the ankles. And that's it. That's pretty much all you get. The head, again, not on a ball joint, just goes back and forth. But to me, really, I've never been someone who complains about that kind of articulation because I don't pose my figures dynamically very often with their heads looking off. I just stand them there like that, and what you see is what you get. So this figure does a really excellent job, I feel, of representing a classic-looking black and gray pouch belt solid bat Batman. And here they are posed right alongside some DC Universe Classic scale Batman and Superman figures. Two Supies, two Batties. Oh, I would like to point out, though, that this Batman, I did remove the black from his mask on this particular version. I do have an untouched one, but I prefer to not have the black on the face. And this is the Mattel Superpowers Anniversary Superman, except for I changed the head because the one that came on it was absolutely atrocious, and I fixed the cape so it actually connects with the cape line. But this is the Superpowers version of Superman. I also would like to point out that these blues are actually not that similar. This blue actually looks a lot more like turquoise when it's not under a bright white light like this is, whereas this blue still looks like a true blue no matter what light you put it under. But there we can see their size comparison. We can see that if you tried to pose this Batman or this Superman alongside some DC Universe classics, they wouldn't quite look right. They just look a little bit too petite to fit in. Anyhow, that's the end of my 2003 Mattel Superman Batman 2-pack unboxing slash review. I appreciate you stopping by the channel to have a look at it with me. That means a lot to me. If you have this Batman Superman 2-pack and have any thoughts on it, any experience with it, and you'd like to let me know down in the comments, that would be really awesome. I'd love to hear from you. Slap a like on the video if you'd like to so that I know that you liked it. And if you think that you would enjoy seeing more content from my channel, please don't hesitate to hit that subscribe button because there's always more videos. And until next time, take care. Bye for now.